Hey guys, Joe here once again with more Madden 17 Franchise Mode Season 1. We're on Game 6, Week 6, whatever you want to call it. We're going to the University of Phoenix Stadium, which is the home of the Arizona Cardinals. We're doing very good so far for our team that we have, especially with Bryce Petty as our quarterback. So let's just get this going cracking, huh? Oh boy, Monday Night Football. Everybody got guilty pleasures. Mine just tend to catch me cases. Handcuffs, police, inspections, lawyers, judges, allegations. Turn on your favorite station. You hear the same old song. I feel like dog about to drop the bomb. Rolling down, passing around. Hey, open me now, we running wild. Hey, nobody getting, we on the town.
Hello everybody, I'm Larry Ridley. Welcome to the NFL on EA Sports. It was a tremendous passing display that this man put on last week. Short, deep, intermediate, he made all the throws. And he had the yards to prove it, not to mention the win. He's riding high coming into this game. It's the Jets going up against the Cardinals. With that, it's time to look up with our commentators in the booth as we turn over to Brandon Godden and Charles Davis.
Thank you very much, Larry. We are about 15 miles west of downtown Phoenix at University of Phoenix Stadium here in Glendale. Tonight, we finish off week 6 with a good Monday nighter between the New York Jets and the Arizona Cardinals. With Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Godden. Charles, you look at this Cardinal team as they get ready here. We're in October now, so everything, everybody...
Ah, man, we get the ball first. Not cool, man. Totally not cool.
Sat with a coaching staff a couple of days ago. They said attacking that defensive look with a run, something they wanted to do, it was effective.
And they were extremely confident, weren't they? Their planning, their preparation, they knew what they were going to get in that defense, and they were able to attack it accordingly.
It's a loss of two there, bringing out second down.
And I know that play didn't work very well, but an old New York Giants quarterback taught me a lesson a long time ago. Sometimes running the draw actually takes courage and play calling. You're actually setting something up for later in the game.
Richard Rodgers.
Because it was unsuccessful then, doesn't mean
should be a first down. Yep.
They pick up 12 on the play there, and they move the chains. And early on, they're picking up right where they left off last week.
And I know a lot of coaches say each game is its own. You don't really have carryover. This feels like carryover. So much confidence from the previous game that they're using to their advantage now.
Decker, the intended receiver. And now it's second down. 10 yards still left on second down. They're going to lift and throw. And it's brought in by Eric Decker.
Nice.
Taken down, but not before getting this inside the 30. And a nice gain of 21 yards.
Quarterbacks love slant routes because the receivers are breaking right into their line of vision. And receivers love them as well because they're getting the ball on the move and able to catch it.
Oh, no. I was trying to get that ball to the noon wall.
And now off to the races.
Oh, he's gone. Pick six. They're gonna score anyway. What? They didn't score on that?
And New York set to take the field.
Wow.
Looked like they had something going last drive. Then the interception happened. Will they recover?
The memory
need to keep whether miss. Then they did.
I'm guessing they missed the field goal. He didn't turn the ball over.
Don't worry about the other part. You can't get that back. Let's go back to what you were doing well before.
I thought you were gonna say they need to have no memory, but remember the good part, forget the bad.
I like that even better.
The Decker's got it.
Go, Decker. Go.
He's at the 30.
That's a touchdown. So after throwing a pick in the first drive, we get a very long touchdown in the second drive.
The Jets offensive unit ready to get going here. And that recipe on their last drive that resulted in a touchdown looked pretty good, so they'll be hoping to do that once more.
That takes me back to when we sat with the offensive coordinator and the head coach. They felt pretty good about their game plan and thought there were some holes in the defense, and they exploited them the last time out. Let's see if they can come back and put together a similar drive.
And we'll see if they can do just that. They run it now, out of the gun. The 30 to the 32. Given 9 on the carry that time, and they're set up with a second and 1.
And that's the end of the first quarter.
Play before the quarter ends. So we played one quarter here on a Monday night. Set with Charles Davis, Brandon Gaudin with you. It's the Jets in possession as we begin quarter number 2 here. They're looking at a second and short yardage to start things out. Going to give this time to the tailback.
Oh, he's gone.
Forte with green grass ahead.
Wow.
And all the way in. Touchdown, New York. Matt Forte.
Awesome. Seems the Cardinals can't get it going.
Back onto the field.
Game can look like a disaster. It probably depends on how the game is going. Is it a series of 1 yard gains running the ball? If that's the case, you might have to start thinking about throwing it a little bit more. But if it's just the
Richard Rodgers.
Hey, congratulations to the defense that won that one.
No, don't tell me he's gone too.
Down the left side, it's a foot race.
I was about to say.
Uh oh. Now as we look down
at
it, shake it up on the play. Well, he gets attended to, we'll step aside.
Damn. And I don't even use Rodgers that much either. He gets injured. Touchdown. Nice. Arizona still can't get it going.
And New York set to take the field. Here's Paddock.
And Nunwa.
And taking it across midfield and inside the 45. And they talked about how important the passing game was going to be against that defensive look. Good job there going to the air for the first down.
It's all about preparation, it's all about planning, and then it's about execution. So it's
all and Nunwa again.
Okay, this is what we think.
Another first down.
This is how they get to it, and then when the game comes, read it and attack it.
Nothing flashy there, the slant to the slot.
All the frustration for the defensive guys, because it's a quick play, and you know it's going to be a bang-bang play in terms of the throw and the catch, and then he's able to absorb the contact.
Yeah.
His throw here is incomplete. They were trying to go to Marshall that time. That'll bring up second down.
Partner, I'm sure you've heard the same thing I've heard along the way. At some point, because of his size, Patrick Peterson may have to shift to safety. But it feels to me like that's a long way away the way he's playing all these routes. How about the way it's exploded on that dig route, not the ball away?
Decker, first down and more. That's a touchdown.
Take it in for a Jets touchdown.
We are blowing them out right now.
Thank you.
Dak and Bernetta catch.
Left side. Well, they'll get 16 yards there. And it's good for a New York first down. So in the second quarter, he's already up over 100 yards receiving now.
And isn't 100 the magic number for a really good game for a receiver? So he got a chance to really shatter that and have a profound effect on this game.
Brandon Marshall.
First catch by Brandon Marshall. And he takes it down deep into Arizona territory. It's a big play that time by the Jets. 37 yards. So after that big play, let's see if they can catch their defense maybe on their heels.
Coaches really don't care from what position they get this, but run after the catch.
Burton. He's already a substitute tight end for Richard Rodgers.
Give him 10 yards on the pickup, and that'll make it second and a foot or so.
Seeing that play and understand just how tough it is to cover tight ends, especially the ones running around the NFL nowadays, makes me glad I didn't make it in that league. I would have had a really difficult time.
But now you get to sit up here with me.
Yeah, and that's fun, isn't it? And what a really nice game right there on first down for him.
I don't know what I was thinking. I didn't see anybody open, so I was trying to get there. Didn't work. Didn't work at all.
Pressure all around him, so the only play was to try and get out of there. I think it was an excellent effort by him just to get back to the line of scrimmage.
On third and short, they'll try and pick it up through the air.
Touchdown, yes. Third quarter now. Arizona got the ball. Still can't do anything.
A look at the offense now here, coming back out on the road for their first possession of the second half. And that last drive, a long drive, but not just that, they had a great air.
Nunwa.
I would think that they would, because if they were confident enough to do it on the last drive, starting backed up in their own territory, why would you change anything? They've got to be confident about what they're presenting and continue to do so.
Yeah, because the secondary, they really look close.
And that was amazing.
Brandon Marshall.
And yet, no adjustments and no good plays by the defense to knock the ball away.
A big play there on the catch and run. 36 yards.
A lot of receivers see the drag route as a risk-reward type of a play. The risk, going into the middle of the field where there's some big people want to hit you. But the reward is oftentimes you get lost in coverage, running a little bit underneath. And when you catch it just right as
Matt Forte.
The end result could be a big, big play.
That one good for 10 yards. And that'll bring up a second and just about a few inches here.
Not an ideal spot to be on first down, but I love that the play caller did not immediately abandon the running game and say, okay, we got to throw it in order to pick it up. Stayed with the run, was rewarded with a big-time pickup. Now they're in second and manageable.
The gain of four that time as the drive continues.
Second and inches is oftentimes an invitation for an offense coordinator to take a big shot downfield because he feels like he can come back on third down and pick up the first down. But sometimes you just don't want to break tendency. Stay with what you are. Stay with who you know and go get the first down. That's exactly
he caught that?
And a diving
quick. Wow.
You got that, yes.
Brandon, we did watch
cool, man.
On tape last week, and it was a lot of fun to watch.
All right, he's giving a forte of him running in.
50 plays, and he's doing it again this week. And what I'm seeing is the rest of his team start to rise in confidence as well.
Running off a little bit?
Nope, he didn't get in.
They're buying into him. They believe in him as their leader, which means that they're going to play better, try to make some better plays for him. I think we've seen that throughout this contest.
Those numbers certainly back you up. Back to throw here. And it's a touchdown for the Jets.
Not running in again. It's okay.
Quarterback.
So the Cardinals are getting dominated at home. Oh, they get a field goal.
And New York set to take the field. And they'll be looking to build off of a nice drive last time. A drive that really relied on the quarterback.
Making good decisions.
And Nunwa. Oh, he's gone.
Now look at him go. Past the 20. And all the way in. Touchdown.
I feel bad too for beating the Cardinals up like this, but
New York set to take the field. And last time, the formula was pretty simple. One play drive, long pass. I think they just want to do that again, right?
And that's exactly how you want to draw things up. Whether it's on your grease board, right, in your playbook, one play drive is exactly what you want on offense. What they have to be careful of is not having a letdown. It was really easy last time. They can't expect that going forward.
Yeah, we'll see if it's that easy here. Heading out. To Decker over.
Oh, he gone.
There goes Eric Decker. And all the way in. Touchdown, New York. Eric Decker with his third touchdown of the.
Yeah, 56-3.
And New York set to take the field.
This is a beat down.
It's a 6-yard gain on the ground, and that'll make it 2nd and 4.
Another good run for him. What else is new? That'll put him right at 150 yards for the game. So he's really made his presence felt in this one.
They'll give it to him right up the gut. And here he'll be brought down a little shy of the 35 at the 36. It's a gain of 4 there, and it gives him a new set of downs.
It's nice every now and then in this game not to see people overthink it. Just hand it to the old reliable guy, let him pick up the first down.
They'll run it now out of the gun. It's a 6-yard pickup and it gets him to 2nd and 4.
You know what really fires up offensive linemen? When the guy that is carrying the ball behind them can create his own space and break a tackle along the way.
He'll come out here in the eye. He'll look to throw. He's just going to dump this one off to his fullback out of the backfield. 9 yards on the pickup there, and it keeps the drive alive.
502 passing yards.
But as you and I both know, that doesn't necessarily mean that's a fullback playing in that spot.
Well, times have changed, right? The old school fullback doesn't really exist anymore.
We're not getting that same player out of college. With all the spread offenses, not very many close style. They actually have a true fullback.
And they are going to score.
Wow.
And yet another touchdown as they just add to their totals.
There's no doubt in my mind.
Brandon Marshall couldn't be stopped there either.
It's not scales,
he had three
right?
Birds on him.
So actually hearing tune being warbled,
and he still pushed his way in.
She's doing more than hum, and she's belted it out right now.
She's full bore.
Yeah, this thing is flat out finished.
The
New York set to take the field.
Yeah, they must have turned the ball over.
Great field position. They got the big lead. Most would say they should kneel it, but the key word there is it should. You never know here.
You never know. That's the exact play that should happen. But some people like stats. You know, some people like to put more things up on the board. But kneel down is usually the right play here.
Let's see what they do in this situation. They'll run it now. Out of the gun. Take this one down near the 15. Call it a gain of a couple, and that's going to leave them with a 3rd and about 5.
Well, I think we know by now that every run is not going to be broken and get all the way to the end zone. But these short ones still have their value. You can still set up to play action and throw the football. You control the clock because you have the ball and they don't. And often the physicality sets the tempo for the game.
Call it a 3-yard.
66-3.
Charles, it's one thing to win, it's another thing to win and put up the amount of points that they do.
Let's see. So I have 138.5 rating, only had 3 incompletions, including the pick. That could have been a pick 6, but I actually stopped them. They still couldn't score on that. 526 passing yards, wow. 85% completions, 5 TDs to 1 pick. Carson Palmer had a bad game. He had 3 picks, no TDs. He only had 164 yards passing, 24-38. Wow. His rating 39.8. Wow. Since when did the Jets have a good D? I don't know. They've had a good D since like what, 2014, or even like 2011. You want to go that far?
Yeah, I've been killing it. Yeah, I've been harder to pick, not a civil assist. Yeah, I've been flicking that wrist. Yeah, I've been killing it, now they fuck with this. Yeah, I've been killing it. Yeah, I've been harder to pick, not a civil assist. Yeah, I've been flicking that wrist. Yeah, I've been killing it, now they fuck with this.
All right, so we're back home. We played a 2-4 Baltimore Ravens. Wow. All right, guys. I'll see you next next game. Adios.